It's Amanda, and I want to come to you briefly on a topic, and that topic is stay in faith. Now, stand on, let the redeemed of the Lord say so, whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy. So I never get on any of these scopes and claim to have it all together. In fact, God said we go from faith to faith and from glory to glory. He says that he will perfect the things which concern of us. So I just want to give a brief word of encouragement to my network. I'm not here to counsel you. I'm not here to go against leadership. In fact, we're called to lift up our leadership, our spiritual covering. Hallelujah. Praise God. So we always continually ask the Lord to undergird them in prayer. Dispatch your minister and angels, Lord. You've given charge over us to keep us in all of our ways. Now let's jump right into the topic. Stay in faith. In Hebrews 11, it states, now faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. Through it, the elders obtained a good report. I'm here to let you know, my dear friend, that despite the lies of the enemies and life circumstances, you can rest assured that God will never leave you and God will never forsake you. For the eye of the Lord is in every place, beholding the good and the evil. Faith is extremely important to hold on to in this walk as the believer. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of their testimony. This is how we overcome in the kingdom. We give our testimony. We share our testimony. Not because we have all of our stuff together, but because God has done an incredible and amazing thing in our lives that we want to share with others. So that's why I'm admonishing you, my dear friend, to stay in faith. You know, man looks at the outward appearance, but God looks at the heart. So understand that before we were formed, God knew us. He knows the very number of hairs on our head, literally. God is a God who has a supernatural intelligence about each and every one of us. So understand that we don't get mad at people, but we wrestle against principalities. We got to cast down these vain imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge and the power of God. So that's why I said stay in faith. Amen. For without faith, it's impossible to please God. For he that comes to God must believe that he is and that he's a rewarder of them who diligently seek him. Is there someone bullying you on the playground, at your job, within your family? Learn how to stay in love, but most importantly, stay in faith. You got to trust that God is a God who will deliver. And when you go into your prayer closet, shut the door. When you pray in secret, God will reward you openly. There's nothing that the enemy is getting away with. But keep in mind, we don't want to become so self-righteous. All have sinned and falling short of the glory of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. So we want to stay in love. We want to stay in forgiveness, but we want to stay in belief because God watches over his word to perform it. He tells us that these signs shall follow them that believe. Stay in faith, my dear friend, for the just shall live by faith. The Lord executes righteousness and judgment for all that are oppressed. Understand that God will deliver on that thing he promised you. Are you standing in faith? What are you releasing out of your mouth? What are you entertaining in your ear and your eye gate? You know? You got to learn that God has not called us to condemnation and shame, but he's called us to victory. Amen. We got to lean on his ability and understand that he's going to put his super on our natural, as I hear one of my teachers say frequently. I'm here to let you know, my dear friend, that if you can only stay in faith, God will deliver on that promise. You will see the manifestation. In Galatians, it states, be not weary in well-doing, for you shall reap in due season if you faint not. As long as the earth remains, there'll be seed time and harvest. Understand, when you sow, you will reap. Hallelujah. Wherefore, by their fruit, you'll know them. The enemy desires to sift us as we, but it doesn't mean that he has the authority to do it. Stay in faith, my dear friend, and be patient with the process that God is taking you through. For I know I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me. Stay in faith and understand that it's your faith that's going to carry you through. Hallelujah. That God has assigned an angelic host to assist you. Stop looking at man as your all in all. Miracles happen every day, my dear friend. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Refuse to let people speak destruction and sickness over your life. For he has healed all of our diseases and he has redeemed our life from every destruction. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. He shall preserve your soul. We bind up retaliatory demons. Jump through the screen. Break now in the name of Jesus. He shall abaseet them. Foul spirits that want to instigate and hold on. It's a new day with new mercy. He shall abide. Mantabrabakuta. I don't know about you, my dear friend, but I'm going to stay in faith. Hallelujah. Fight the good fight of faith and don't give in, hallelujah, to the pressure. Mashalaba, utaba, mantabra, find accountability partners. Make sure that you're praying because God, hallelujah, will deliver. Stay in faith, my dear friend, hallelujah, and understand that God has heard your cry and he will deliver you. Shalom.